Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm Dr. Alvin Alva and I'm a consultant pathologist. In this video, we're going to talk about the different types of diabetes. There are two major subtypes of diabetes, type 1 and type 2. First, let's look at type 1 diabetes. Type 1 diabetes was previously known as insulin-dependent diabetes mellitus. This type of diabetes usually occurs in children and adolescents. The pancreas is an organ present close to the stomach, which has different cells that release enzymes. These cells of the pancreas are destroyed by the body's own immune system. In contrast to type 2 diabetes, type 1 diabetes is caused due to the destruction of these beta cells of the pancreas, which produce insulin. What triggers this destruction is not clearly known, but it is postulated that certain viral illnesses in childhood and those with a family history of type 1 diabetes or those with lower vitamin D levels are at a higher risk of developing type 1 diabetes. In type 1 diabetes, there are mutations in several genes and not just a single genetic mutation that is responsible. Those with type 1 diabetes are incapable of producing any insulin or produce very little insulin. Because of this, they have to be provided with insulin from the outside. Individuals with type 1 diabetes are more likely to develop short-term and long-term complications. We'll talk more about the complications of diabetes in the next video. Type 2 diabetes, on the other hand, is seen in individuals more than 40 years of age and develops due to resistance of the action of insulin rather than a deficiency of insulin. In fact, in the early stages of the disease, the body may produce more than normal amounts of insulin to compensate for the insulin resistance. Insulin resistance means that insulin does not act on the tissues in the way it's supposed to act. As with type 1 diabetes, there are several genetic mutations associated with the development of type 2 diabetes. However, type 2 diabetes has a much stronger genetic component when compared to type 1. For example, if an individual has a parent with type 2 diabetes, that person has about 40% chance of developing type 2 diabetes. But if both the parents have type 2 diabetes, then the risk of developing type 2 diabetes increases drastically up to 80 to 90%. Along with genetic mutations, there are several other risk factors that may increase the likelihood of developing diabetes. These risk factors include being overweight, having a waist circumference of more than 40 inches in males and more than 35 inches in females. Those with central obesity, which means that fat is deposited around the abdomen, are more likely to develop insulin resistance. Other risk factors include lack of physical activity, increased age, high blood pressure, abnormal lipids, history of heart disease, and any other associated diseases like polycystic ovarian disease. Other types of diabetes include gestational diabetes and maturity onset diabetes of the young. Gestational diabetes means diabetes that develops during pregnancy. This is seen in an individual who has a family history of gestational diabetes or who develop rapid weight gain during pregnancy or are overweight before pregnancy. These risk factors increase the likelihood of developing diabetes during pregnancy. Usually this type of diabetes resolves after pregnancy, but such individuals have a high risk of developing type 2 diabetes in the future. Those with gestational diabetes may give birth to a large size baby and have a history of a large size baby in the previous pregnancy. Maturity onset diabetes of the young is a type of diabetes when there is a single genetic mutation which interferes with the release of insulin from the pancreas. These individuals are usually less than 25 years of age and are non-obese and have impaired glucose control because of insufficient release of insulin from the pancreas. To sum it up, type 1 diabetes is seen in children and adolescents because of destruction of the beta cells by the body's own immune system, and these individuals are completely dependent on insulin. Type 2 diabetes is seen in older individuals and develops in individuals due to a combination of genetic mutations and several risk factors. This leads to development of insulin resistance. Over the years, the pancreas cannot cope up to produce sufficient insulin, and eventually, even type 2 diabetics become dependent on insulin. Gestational diabetes is diabetes that develops during pregnancy in individuals who have risk factors. Maturity onset diabetes of the young is a type of diabetes seen in young, non-obese individuals due to a single genetic mutation which prevents the release of insulin from the pancreas. I hope you like this video. Stay tuned for more videos like these and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. In the next video, we're going to talk about the symptoms of diabetes. See you in the next video.